Dear learners, very good morning to all of you. Just stay connected. Very shortly, our resource person will be joining the class. Dear learners, stay connected. Very shortly, our resource person will be joining the class. Thank you so much.
परीक्षा सर पहले से 2 मिनट रहे अभी ऑनलाइन ऑप्शन है ना ऑप्शन है ना
यस सर डियर लर्नर्स वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू आवर रिसोर्स पर्सन डॉक्टर मनोज चौधरी हैज जॉइंड So I welcome all of you. At the same time, I welcome Mr. Prithviraj Mishra, who is an academic consultant with Odisha State Open University. Mr. Kirod Marana, an academic consultant with Odisha State Open University. Mr. Avishek Singh, welcome. At the same time, I thank two of the technical persons, Mr. Debidatta Behra and Swagatika Behra. So thank you so much for giving support. So I would request Mr. Prithviraj Mishra to formally introduce our resource person to the learners.
Thank you, Paricha sir. Good morning to all of you. And Dr. Manoj Chaudhary, assistant professor, Saraswati University, Maharashtra. He is a known face. He has already taken five sessions I have online classes of two different subjects, and sir is well acquainted with our learners also. So without wasting any more time, I request Dr. Chaudhary to begin the today's online session for the benefits of the learners. I am thankful to Sri Pariksha for giving an opportunity to introduce Dr. Chaudhary, and I hope the class would be a lively one. Thank you, sir. Thank you all. I request Dr. Chaudhary to initiate the discussion on the today's topic. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
सर चौधरी सर माइक को अनम्यूट कीजिएगा।
अब आ रहा सर आवाज?
हाँ सर सुनाई दे रहा है सर।
हाँ यस सर यू आर प्रीटी ऑडिबल।
यस सर सर स्लाइड इज विजिबल। हेलो
नो सर नॉट यू
यू आर नॉट शेयर सर।
ओके कर दे
Is it visible now, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. Today, our topic of discussion is business plan and project. We have already discussed about the fundamentals of entrepreneurship, entrepreneurial skill, and other basic topics. Now, how to go for finance? How to initiate your business once you have decided to enter any business? And if we broadly explain business plan is basically the blueprint of your future business activities. Whatever business you are will be doing, how you will be doing, this business plan will be a blueprint. With the help of this business plan, you will be in a position to approach different people and organizations, financial institutions for finances. You can go for different type of formalities from different government or authorities. So let us see in detail now. In this block, we will be discussing business plan presentation, project financing. Then in unit 2, market feasibility, technical feasibility, and financial feasibility viability. Then in unit 3, how to prepare a project report. And then last, we will discuss project appraisal. So let us start with our unit 1. So in introduction part, for any entrepreneur planning to start a business, writing a business plan is helpful way to obtain clarity on the business goal and how to reach them. Business plan is basically how, what will you will be doing, how you will be doing. This is also basically a type of planning, and it will be related to your business activities. What will be your goal for business? How to reach those goals? Everything will be there in your plan. Then comprehensive business plan is the result of discussion and reflection on the direction of the venture. And business plan are considered as mandatory step for entrepreneurs seeking funding from venture capitalists or bank. Different type of financials are there. Later on, we will discuss to whom we can approach as an entrepreneur, a startup for finance. So it will be mandatory, because if you are going to explain them orally, that will not work. So you will have to produce a documented plan so that they can see the feasibility of your business, and accordingly they take decision about financing or non-financing your business. This is a formal definition of business plan. A business plan is a written document that gives detail of all aspects the proposed venture. It describes the current status, expected requirement, and projected result of the new venture. Means what is your current status, what will be the requirements, and also what will be the result. Because whenever we go to any banks especially, or any financial institution, they are ready to give you any amount, but the only thing they ensure is your returning capacity. You will be in a position to return those finances or not. Or if some people are investing in your business, then they will be looking for the potential of that business, that they will get profit or not, they will be the beneficial or not. These are some of the various components of a business plan. First one is the executive summary. Executive summary is basically presenting the business plan, detailed business plan in nutshell. Briefly, when you are giving a snapshot basically of your detailed plan, that will be under executive summary, and executive summary should be in the starting of your plan. Then business description, what type of business you will be doing, what will be your product, what will be everything related to your business, where you will be doing, what type of technology or whatever machinery or production process you will be using. Then marketing, once you will produce some product, you will have to market it. How you will be marketing it, in detail we will see all these things. Operations, management, financial, critical, and milestone schedule. So let us see all these components in detail. I have already discussed about executive summary. Executive summary is basically the highlights of your business plan. Then coming to business description, in business description you will have to give detail about general description of the business, industry background, the industry in which you are going to start your business, then goals of the business, and uniqueness of business, product and service. What is uniqueness of your business? How different your product is from the existing product available in the market? How your services will be better than the competitors? Because if you are providing similar product, similar services which are already there established in market, then people may not go for that. So what is the uniqueness of your business, product and services? Then marketing. First, before starting any business, you will have to do some research. Where is the gap? Which are the needs and wants of consumers which are not satisfied by existing products? So in research and analysis, you will have to first identify a target market. The product and services you will be producing, in which market you will be targeting, where will be your consumers. Then market size and trends, what will be your market size. Initially you will be going for a single geographical location or single market, then diversifying, or at same time you will go for multiple market or larger size of market. Then the competition, your product and service will be competing with whom, which are the already existing products and services which is providing similar benefits to the consumers. Then estimated market share, after some time what will be your market share. Suppose after 1 year, how much market you will be in a position to capture from the competitors, and how you will grow. Then marketing plan, what will be your market strategy, how you will be selling and distributing. You will be selling directly to the consumers, or you will be going through the intermediaries, or you will have some distributors, you will go in franchise system, whatever process of your sale and distribution will be. Then pricing. Pricing is again, you might have studied in your marketing management papers. And I was going through the list of papers in that you are having a marketing management paper. So pricing depends on the nature of the product. some products are initially sold at a higher price, then its price come down slowly. Some products are initially offered at lower price. Does that we say penetration pricing is there or scheming pricing is there? So pricing has to be accordingly decided. Then advertising and promotion, how you will be communicating to the target market or target consumers about your product and services. For a startup, advertising and promotion is a difficult task because advertising and promotion is a costly activity. So how you will be doing it? Either you will be doing through the retailers. You might have seen on some retailers outlet, some pamphlets or posters are pasted, or they are giving some extra benefit to the retailers to promote their product. Because they are initially not in a position to go for mass advertising, either it is electronic media or print media. Even nowadays, many offers are there, many you can say possibilities are there where you can give even on national new TV channel, on any national TV channel, only for your geographical location. Suppose if your business is in Odisha, you can advertise only in Odisha on any national channels, either it is entertainment channel, Star Plus or new channel Aaj Tak. So that will be much more economical. So facilities are there, but still advertising and promotion is a bit difficult task for startups. Then what will be the operational activities? First, identify location. You will have to see advantages and disadvantages of a particular location. At some location, you will get better facilities in terms of water supply, electricity, or you can say you can get some economical labor, or you will have market close to your location of manufacturing. Then zoning will be there. Taxes, every state and every location is having different taxation policy. Then proximity to supplier, how close you are to your supplier and also how close you are to the market. Then logistics details, from where you will be getting logistics, how frequently you will be getting those logistics and everything. Then this management decision you will have to take. What will be your management team? Who will be your key personals? Either you will be going through your friends or people whom you know about their nature, or you will go for some industry expert, or you will go for some experienced people in that sector. Then legal structure will be there. Equity agreement, employment agreement, ownership. What type of equity agreement you will have, what type of employment agreement you will be having. Even organizations are bound by many legal obligations. Otherwise, this current government in previous tenure of our central government, they have came with a policy that for first 3 years, to a particular limit is given, the entrepreneurs will not have much legal formalities. They need not to go for all the legal formalities. So government is also coming with such policies which will promote, or entrepreneurs will be comfortable in doing business in those things, because employment agreement again is having many issues and other many things. Then who will be your board of directors, advisors and consultants? So all these things has to be decided in the management section, because on these factors the financing will be affected. Then financing, in this financial forecast, what will be the cash flow? How much you will be in spending? What will be the cash outflow? What will be the nature of cash inflow? Then profit and loss, break even analysis. You must be aware about the break even analysis. Break even is basically a point where organization is at no profit, no loss. Again, we have different methods of calculating it. One is traditional method, where if you are spending 50 lakh and you have earned 50 lakh, you will be at the break-even analysis. But if you are spending 50 lakh today and you are earning it after 2 years, 50 lakh today will not have same value as 50 lakh of 2 years later. So discounted method and other many methods are there. Then how you will be controlling cost? Next one is critical risk. What will be the risk? As we have discussed again and again, that business is always associated with risk. So potential challenges will be there. Challenges related to getting approval from different authorities, challenges from your competitor, challenges related to other many things. Then obstacles and risk. Then alternative course of action. If some problem arises, then what will be your alternative course of action? How? What is your plan to come out of those? Then milestone schedule, potential. This has been repeated, I think. So milestone schedules can be there. At what point of time? How much you will be achieving? These three points are of critical risk only. So milestone will be the different stages of your business. When you will be doing your business, what will be the different stages, and at different stages what will you be achieving? Then what will be the characteristics of a good business plan? When your business plan will be considered as a good business plan? So first it should have clear, unambiguous and realistic financial projections. They should be in a standard format and presented clearly. Means things should be clear after studying it. If you are going to some individual, suppose you are going to your friend to associate him with your business, or any person or any financial institution, those institutions and persons should be able to understand your business plan easily. Then detailed market research, reflecting the market knowledge of the entrepreneur. So what type of market research you have done? Because randomly you cannot start. If some potential is there in the market, then only you must start your business. So what type of research you have done, and what is your knowledge about the market? Then detailed competitor research. You are not doing business in isolation. You are not the only one. There are still many national, multinational companies there in every sector. So you have to do analysis of your competitor. Then a strong management team who exhibit the potential of carrying the project to success. As we discussed in management, what type of people, what type of directors you will be having, who will be your advisors, who will be your consultants. Then a crisp executive summary with a statement of what the company is seeking. Executive summary is basically the highlights of your business, or we can say you are presenting your complete business plan in nutshell. So it should be more attractive, so that first every individual or financial institution will go through first executive summary. And if it is not good, then they may not go for studying the detailed business plan. So the executive summary should be very promising. Then a good business plan should provide proof of vision of the entrepreneur to the audiences. तो एक अच्छा बिजनेस प्लान होता है, ये एक सबूत होना चाहिए कि जो एंटरप्रेन्योर है उसका विजन क्या है. देन वेल रिटन बिजनेस प्लान व्हिच इज इंटरेस्टिंग टू रीड एज वेल एज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड, जो उसको पढ़ने में भी अच्छा इंटरेस्टिंग होना चाहिए, और वो एक प्रॉपर तरीके से ऑर्गेनाइज्ड होना चाहिए. स्टेप बाय स्टेप जो भी इसके कंटेंट्स होने चाहिए वो सारे अरेंज्ड होने चाहिए, एंड इन बेस्ट वे इट शुड बी प्रेजेंटेड. Keep the plan short, fewer than 50 pages is a good goal. So nearly 40 to 50 pages ka desired business plan hona chahiye. Ek standard format mein hona chahiye. Aisa nahi ki wo bahut chote font hai, readable nahi hai, ya bahut sari cheeze dalni hai. Means kehne ka matlab ye hai ki usme aapko most of the relevant informations hi keval dalni hai. Then next one is types and sources of financing for startups. What type of finance you can get? from where you will get finance, because it is generally said that if business is a vehicle, finance is fuel of that business. Without finance, you cannot run any business. So first source can be personal finance, then borrowing from family and friends, angel investors, venture capitalists, debt financing, and equity financing. Let us see in detail one by one what are these finances and what are the advantages and disadvantages of using these finances. So personal finance is basically your own savings or your own assets which you are using, own capital which you are using for business, especially for sole proprietors. In most of the cases, they start their business with personal finances. These are the few advantages and disadvantages of personal finances. If we go through first advantages, first one is acquisition cost and time are minimized. You have money with yourself, it will not cost anything, and you will not need not to invest much more time to get that finance, because it is already with you. You can start spending and investing for your business. Entrepreneurs keeps control on the business. Here you are not taking finance from anyone. If we talk about other type of finance, later on we will see if you are taking finance from suppose bank or some venture capitalist, if we talk about venture capitalist, they will go for share only. If you are going for bank debts, if you are not able to return regularly after this defaulter of few installments, banks may overtake your business to get back their finance. So here entrepreneur keeps 100% control on the business. Then display commitment to other prospective investors. It will show that you are investing your own finance also, so other people may feel safe in investing their capital. Then low startup cost, which does not require large capital. The startup cost, if is low, then you will not require large capital and you are starting with your own finance. As the founder, lend the money to the startup to earn return at later stage. Means you are spending your money in a startup and will earn, and whatever return will be, it will be yours only. But if you are going through some associating some other people, you will have to share your earnings and profits. Then next one, there are some disadvantages also. So disadvantages of personal finances. Personal finance may not be sufficient to let the business sail smoothly through few certain phases. Means personal finance may not be sufficient. Suppose an individual might not have sufficient amount to start a business, or for initial few phases you may start with your own finance, but later on you will require more finances. Then risk of losing all the personal savings. Here you will lose all your savings if your business is not becoming successful, so it is always there. And if you are going through the venture capital or angel finances or other ways, you will not lose 100% your finance. Then putting personal and family future at risk in case of acquired losses. If losses are there, your personal financial loss will be there, and that will lead to your personal and family's future at risk. Some assets such as ETF accounts are safe from creditors and bankruptcy courts. Placing such asset at risk may not be good. Then next one is borrowing from family and friends. Advantages and disadvantages of borrowing from family and friends is also similar to the personal finance. Here are some of the precautions which an entrepreneur should take while borrowing from this source. Either you are getting from family, you are getting from your father's saving, your family members, your relatives, your friends. So the precautions which should be taken care is, ask for a specific amount to meet a specific milestone. means you ask for only that amount which you need for doing something, then offer a formal agreement at the time of borrowing how you will be returning, because if you are taking from your friend or family also, you will have to return, so you must go through a formal agreement, or that you will be either sharing profit or you will be returning them with some or whatever things will be there. Let them see your own investment and commitment, what type of investment you yourself are making and what are your commitments related to your business. Then build a prototype first on your own time and money, then communicate the plan and the risks up front. Means whatever, what is your plan and what will be risk associated, you must communicate a risk to the individuals whom you are approaching for finance. Then tie repayment to revenue growth in the startup. जो repayment का क्या होगा, क्योंकि कोई भी जब आपको पैसा देता है तो उसको repayment के बारे में सबसे पहले assure करना जरूरी होता है. Then next source of finance can be angel investors. Angel investors are basically those people who are having their own surplus money, their savings. They are individuals and majorly they invest in a business to get some share of that business. They may go for 10 to 30%. Even we all know that minimum more than 50% shares must be with the entrepreneur, then only they will have the entrepreneur will have ownership of that business. So angel investors are basically individuals who invest in others idea, others planning, and get return in terms of profits or whatever surplus business will generate. Here advantages of angel investor being invested is being successful entrepreneur themselves. They bring expert advice for the entrepreneur without any additional fee. If you are going for some consultant or some other experts, you will have to pay fee for their advices. Here angel investor may be the entrepreneur themselves, and they will give you advice without any fee, because their interest is also in your business. If business will do good, business will earn profit, they will also the beneficiary. They are geography or sector specific investors. Geographical, or they can be from your geographical location only, or similar sector or related sector. More permissive in nature. Then prefer a startup at early stage and seek a smaller deals. They go for a small deals and associate with startups. They are usually part of a network which is useful in case of requirement of additional funds. They are having good network, so if some additional fund is required at later stage, they will be in a position to arrange those funds. Then there are some disadvantages of angel investors as well. They lend little or no follow on money. Means once they have invested, they will be looking for return only. If some subsequent money is required, then they will be hesitant in investing that type of money. Then they insist on a say in management of the company. Means they will be looking for some position in the management of the company, and accordingly they will influence the decisions of the company. Then since agreements are largely informal and less comprehensive, they may turn the founder out of the company. Means jo agreement hota hai wo informal hota hai aur kam comprehensive hota hai, isliye kai baar wo log fir overtake kar lete hain company ko. ठीक है, और फाउंडर को ही कंपनी से फिर निकाल कर उस कंपनी को ओवरटेक कर लेते. दे आर जनरली रीजन स्पेसिफिक, हैंस डू नॉट हैव नेशनल इमेज टू लीवरेज. वो लोकल लोग होते हैं, रीजनल स्पेसिफिक होते हैं, इसलिए उनका कोई नेशनल इमेज नहीं होता कुछ खास. देन वेंचर कैपिटल, Venture capital are also venture capitalists are basically employees of the venture capital organizations. They are basically institutional investors, and their nature is also similar to this angel investors. The only difference is angel investors are individual or group of individuals, and venture capitalists are basically representatives of venture capital organizations. So some advantages are here. Since venture capital funding is not a loan scheme, there is no repay schedule. Means if you incur losses, you will not have to repay that. Venture capitals have consultants and professionals on their staff with knowledge of a specific market. They are basically organizations, and they have a group of employees who are having knowledge of market and industry. Since VCs will hold a percentage of equity in the business, they have a say in management, compensating for the inexperience of the new entrepreneur. New entrepreneur might not have a good amount of this experience, so they will be compensating that. Then VCs often provide HR support to hire right talent who can manage various functions in the company. Getting right talent for the organizations again is a big challenge. So they will help in that process. Because VC firms are under strict supervision of regulatory bodies, there are very few or no unscrupulous VCs. Means they are organizations, they are under regulatory bodies. So that type of problem will not be there. VCs firms are very easy to locate because they are documented in business directories. They are having registration, they are having a particular location, offices are there. So they are very easy to locate. These are some of the disadvantages. Some VC firms require higher return on investment, which can amount to as much as 60% of the equity that make VC the owner of the company. If we go by that 60% share, then they will have ownership. Usually VC firm will want to add a member of their team on company's management team, which can create internal problem. They will be influencing decision process, decision-making process, and another thing. All key decisions have to be informed to VC who have the power to override such decisions. Whatever जो भी decision entrepreneur अपने organization में लेगा, उन सभी decisions की सूचना VC को देना अनिवार्य होता है, और उसको वो मना भी कर सकता है वैसा वो decision लेने से. VC firms usually refuse to sign a non-disclosure agreement. This and put your ideas. At risk. अब जैसे जो भी है, what is going on? VCs firm usually refuse to sign a non-disclosure agreement. यदि आप कुछ non-disclosure agreement sign करना चाहते हैं, then they may refuse to sign that. तो और वो फिर आपके आइडिया के लिए रिस्क हो जाएगा, आपके आइडिया को वो इम्प्लीमेंट नहीं होने देगा. Venture capitalists take very long to decide whether to invest in your business or not, since they are looking for big profits. They are there toward profit only. They do not have any interest in anything except profit. So they first analyze and go through your business plan so that they will be in a position to earn good profit. Most VC firms release fund in stages with an eye on the expansion of this approach may not be suitable for company's funding plan and cause disruption. Means वो जो venture capitalist होते हैं वो अलग अलग stages में fund आपको release करते हैं, starting में ही नहीं कर देते, उससे भी फिर problem आती है. Usually VC firm want their investment back within 3 to 5 years. For a business with longer gestation, VC funding is not मे नॉट बी सुटेबल। उनका टारगेट होता है कि जो भी उन्होंने इन्वेस्ट किया है वो ज्यादा से ज्यादा 3 से 5 साल में वापस मिल जाए, और यदि कोई एंटरप्रेन्योर या स्टार्टअप लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए कोई बिजनेस करता है तो उसके लिए फिर ये ज्यादा डिजायर्ड नहीं होता है। डेट फाइनेंसिंग बेसिकली वी कैन टेक हेयर एज लोन्स फ्रॉम फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस और मेजरली बैंक्स, और इसके भी अपने एडवांटेज हैं। यदि आप फाइनेंस के डिफरेंट पेपर्स में पढ़े होंगे तो डेट जो है वो सबसे सस्ता सोर्स ऑफ फाइनेंस माना जाता है। देन एडवांटेजेस ऑफ डेट फाइनेंसिंग, नो रिलिंक्विशमेंट ऑफ ओनरशिप। जो डेट फाइनेंसिंग होता है उसमें कोई ओनरशिप नहीं का वो डिमांड नहीं करते, एक्सेप्ट यू बिकम अ डिफॉल्टर। जब तक आप डिफॉल्टर नहीं बनते तब तक आपका किसी भी प्रोसेस में वो कोई इंटरफेयर नहीं करेगा। आपको जो डिसीजन लेना हो, जैसा कि हमने वेंचर कैपिटल में या एंजल वाले में देखा कि उसमें इंटरफेरेंस रहता है मैनेजमेंट में, यहाँ डेट फाइनेंसिंग में कोई इंटरफेरेंस नहीं रहता। मोर बोरोइंग अलाउ फॉर ग्रेटर रिटर्न ऑन इक्विटी। जितना आप ज्यादा बोरो करेंगे उतना ज्यादा रिटर्न कमाने की संभावना बढ़ती है। Borrowing cost is low during period of low interest rates. Abhi it is best time. Government ne RBI ne bahut sare apne rates slash kiye hain jisse loans kafi saste ho gaye hain. Other many advantages are there. Later on we will see some government initiatives. Then there are some disadvantages also. Regular interest payment are required. Aapne profit kamaya ya nahi kamaya, aapko interest pay karna hi hai. ये एडवांटेज वहाँ वेंचर कैपिटल या अदर टाइप में था कि आपको रेगुलर पेमेंट नहीं करना है। इनिशियली सपोज करो आप पहले 6 महीने तक यदि प्रॉफिट नहीं जनरेट करना है तो वहां पे आपको एक भी पैसा किसी को नहीं देना, यहाँ आपको फिर भी इंटरेस्ट पे करते रहना है या जो इंस्टॉलमेंट डिसाइड हुआ है उस इंस्टॉलमेंट को पे करना ही है। सो दे माइट बी गोइंग फ्रॉम योर कैपिटल। कैश फ्लो कैन कम अंडर ड्यूरेस ड्यू टू पे बैक कमिटमेंट। जैसा कि मैंने आपको बताया कि आपको पेमेंट करना ही है तो आपका कैश फ्लो उसकी वजह से अंडर प्रेशर आ जाएगा। हैवी यूज ऑफ डेट कैन इनहिबिट ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट। यदि ज्यादा यूज करते हैं आप डेट का तो उससे ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट इफेक्ट होगा। नॉन पेमेंट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट एंड प्रिंसिपल कैन रिजल्ट इन अकाउंट बीइंग टर्म्ड एज एनपीए। और जब आपका अकाउंट नॉन परफॉर्मिंग एसेट डिक्लेयर हो जाता है, अभी जैसे जहां मैं वर्धा में हूँ वहां पे एक बहुत बड़ी कंपनी है लॉयड्स, एंड लॉयड्स के एक मेरे स्टूडेंट हैं बैंक मैनेजर, ही वाज डिस्कसिंग विद मी कि जो 4-5 बैंकों ने उसको फाइनेंस किया है उन्होंने उसको चारों पांचों ने मिलके उस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को ओवरटेक कर लिया है क्योंकि टाइमली रिटर्न नहीं मिल रहा था, एंड दे आर ऑन देयर मैनेजमेंट टॉप मैनेजमेंट। Then equity financing is when you are inviting people to purchase your shares and they are having some ownership share in the organization. It is having again this advantages, some advantages, and let us go with few advantages and we will move. First one is with equity financing. With equity financing, there is no loan to repay. Thus, there is lesser financial burden on the business. जो आपका ये debt में disadvantage था, that is advantage here क्योंकि यहाँ पे आपको regular repay नहीं करना है. Since there is not monthly payment to the financing institution, entrepreneur can channel more money into growing the business. Even equity में यदि आप profit generate किया भी है, quarterly, half yearly या annually इसमें डिविडेंड अनाउंस किया जाता है, डिविडेंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूट किया जाता है, बट इट इज नॉट मैंडेटरी। इफ बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स टेक डिसीजन टू होल्ड दोज प्रॉफिट्स एंड डू नॉट डिस्ट्रीब्यूट डिविडेंड, देन यू विल गेट मोर अमाउंट फॉर इन्वेस्टिंग इट इन बिजनेस प्रोसेस। जस्ट गो थ्रू अदर एडवांटेजेस, वी विल मूव टू डिसएडवांटेज नाउ। Here disadvantage of equity financing is share profit with investors, thereby reducing the liquidity of the business. You will have to share your profit. यदि आप dividend नहीं भी invest कर रहे हैं तो जो आप reinvest कर रहे हैं company में वो भी उसमें भी जो financiers होते हैं, equity shareholders होते हैं, उनको वो benefit मिलता है। The price to pay the equity financing and all of its potential advantages is that entrepreneur has to share control of the company. Again, whatever, जैसे अलग अलग तरीके के इक्विटी शेयर्स होते हैं, प्रेफरेंस शेयर एंड अदर मेनी शेयर्स आर देयर, सम आर हैविंग वोटिंग राइट्स, सो योर डिसीजन विल बी इफेक्टेड बाय दोज पीपल. देन देयर इज पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ होस्टाइल टेक ओवर बाय अदर्स. शेयरिंग ओनरशिप कैन रिजल्ट द पोटेंशियल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट विद अदर्स कुड लीड टू सम टेंशन एंड इवन कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इफ देयर आर डिफरेंसेस इन विजन, इफ इन्वेस्टर्स विजन इज डिफरेंट. These are some of the government schemes. These schemes are there to promote entrepreneurial activity in the country. So first one is credit guarantee fund scheme for micro, small and medium enterprises. Study we have discussed about MSME. So there is some credit guarantee fund scheme by government. Then credit link capital subsidy scheme for technology upgradation on different types of technological upgradation, government is providing subsidies. Then a small industry development bank of India, SIDBI, is there, which is has been specially established for growth of business. Then National Small Industries Corporation Limited, NSIC, is there. Hopefully we will discuss these institutions and their functions in last block in detail. Then NSIC, after NSIC, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, NABARD, is there. Then Market Development Assistance Scheme for SMEs, how to market their product, because for startup businesses, doing marketing of their product is not that easy. Then next we have technology and quality upgradation support to micro, small and medium enterprises, how they can upgrade their technology, how they can improve the quality of their product. Then mini tools room and training center schemes. Trainings are again very costly, so government provides training to the small entrepreneurs so that they can will be in a position to compete with existing competition in the market. So we are through with our first unit. Now we are moving to our second unit, that is market feasibility, technical feasibility and financial viability. So here few definitions are there. First one is feasibility analysis. In these analysis we will see how your project is feasible, whatever plan you have presented, is it feasible in the current situation or not. So this under feasibility analysis is an analysis and evaluation of a proposed project to determine if it is technically feasible within the estimated cost and with the will be profitable. Means whatever cost you will be incurring, is it feasible for those costs and will it be profitable or not? Then comes market feasibility study. In this market feasibility study, it determines the depth and condition of a particular market and its ability to support a particular development. Whatever the market position is, your product will be able to succeed or not. Then financial feasibility is there. Later on again we will in detail we will see all these things. Financial feasibility is a study to determine the financial viability of a venture on whether to the borrowed capital and expected cash flow are sufficient to complete the project and to cover annual debt service requirement. Whatever debt requirement will be there, what your finance available finances are sufficient to complete all those activities. Then technical feasibility and operational feasibility. I hope there is some problem in slide display. So next in technical, it is a measure of how well a proposed system solves the problem and take advantage of the opportunities identified during a scope definition and how it satisfies the requirement identified in the requirement analysis phase of system development. So basically, operationally or technically, how you are feasible. Then next comes the concept of feasibility.
Dr. Chaudhary, may I request you to share slide again?
Sir, I am trying to do it, but it is having some problem.
If it is possible, then it can be mailed to anybody else.
Yes, sir. Please give me email.
Kiro sir. Yes, sir. Jodi apan ko mail kar dele, senu apan share nahi karbe kya?
What mail?
Hello.
Yes, we can do it.
Yes, sir.
Are you facing any problem there?
Yes, Dr. Chaudhary is facing in sharing slide. So if we can share, then it will be beneficial to our learners.
Sure. Mail kiya hai kya? Kiro ke paas mail kiya hai kya PPT? Sir, mail kar diya na? Kya time
mail karega? Mail ID bataiye sir, main within seconds.
Haan, theek hai sir.
P.Mishra
right sir.
At the rate Prithviraj sir, apan kar mail ID ta na likhi do message box re.
At the rate hello
OSOU
SOU
dot SC dot A.
Yes. I have emailed it, sir.
Okay, sir. You may continue. You may continue within that time. We'll be sharing that.
Yes. So okay. This in concept of feasibility study. Feasibility study is a preliminary evaluation of a business idea to see if it's worth pursuing. Means, यदि आप कुछ business plan present कर रहे हैं, तो इस feasibility study ये बताएगा कि इसके करने से फायदा है या नहीं है. बिकॉज बिजनेस में कोई भी आपके प्लान में इन्वेस्ट करेगा या कोई भी आपको फाइनेंस करेगा, वो यही देखेगा कि आपके सक्सेसफुल होने के चांसेस कितने हैं. देन कॉमन फिजिबिलिटी फैक्टर्स टेस्टेड इन मोस्ट स्मॉल बिजनेस फिजिबिलिटी असेसमेंट इंक्लूड द फॉलोइंग. पर्सनल फिजिबिलिटी इज देयर, मार्केट फिजिबिलिटी इज देयर, फाइनेंशियल फिजिबिलिटी इज देयर, इकोनॉमिक फिजिबिलिटी इज देयर, technical feasibility is there, location feasibility is there, and legal feasibility is there. So here we will be majorly discussing market, financial, and technical. Now, next one, before going through these feasibility analysis, here is a list of reasons why ventures fail. These are some common reasons, and later on we'll see some specific related to market problem, financial or managerial. So first, common reasons are lack of experienced management. Initially, if some people on management is not much experienced, chances of failure will be more. Then few trained or experienced manpower, poor financing management, financial management, then rapid growth, lack of business linkage, weak marketing efforts, lack of information is there, incorrect pricing, the pricing which you have done is not perfect. Then improper inventory control, your market is having huge demand, your product is having huge demand in market and you are not able to supply on time. So consumer will not wait, they will shift to the substitute product. Then short-term outlook, you are focusing more on short-term benefit rather than planning for longer term as well. You have to earn profit in shorter period of time. At the same time, you will have to plan for longer period also. Then these are some of the other reasons for failure. Either it is product or market problem. Financial difficulty is there. Managerial problem is there. Production and operation problem is there. Or general macroeconomic, means external environment or regulatory problem is there. So first we go through this product or market problem. It is poor timing resulting in premature launch of product and service, product or service. If you are not launching your product on proper time, if your product is related to, so hope some Diwali season is appropriate time for launching your product and you are launching your product just after Diwali, then chances of failure of your product will be high. Then delayed entry in highly competitive market. Once, suppose if we talk about this COVID pandemic, those companies which has entered late with the sanitizer, they did not get good benefit. Those who were there and or initially when entered into market, they must have generated good profit. So delayed entry in highly competitive market will be one of the reason. Poor product design, your product is not having good design. Inappropriate distribution strategy. Then high dependence on a small niche market. You are basically targeting only a small market. Wrong assessment of the completion and wrong estimation of demand. These things may lead to failure. Then financial difficulties are there. Problem in obtaining financing after initial deploying personal finance. Initially you have invested your all the savings and later on when you need finance you are not able to get it from anywhere. Initial undercapitalization resulting in inadequate working capital and cash flow problem, then assuming large debt too early, because if you are getting more and more debts, your process will be more complicated because you will have to pay returns. Problem with the angel investor or venture capitalist, whatever they are interfering in your decision making, they are not allowing you to do your business in your own way. Funds not released by venture capital in response to missed milestones. In the disadvantage of venture capitalist also we have seen. Venture capitalist regularly if they are not releasing funds. Then managerial problem can be there. Inappropriate, inexperienced people hired. Then costly hiring. You have hired some people who are of very high salary. then hiring and responsibility allocation on the basis of personal relationship rather than experience and qualification. You are hiring people because of some references and others. It is again one of the myth of this entrepreneurship that your best friend can be your best business partner. So it doesn't happen. So people should be hired on the basis of their qualification and experience only. Bootstrapping due to lack of funding, retention and employee morale issue, interference by venture capitalists and other investors, and ineffective leadership. These can be some of the managerial issues. Then next we have production and operation problem. Production and operation problem is also inadequate and irregular supply of raw material. You are not having sufficient raw material on time. Or quality control issue. Quality control is not efficient. Lack of warehousing and storage issue. Non-availability of skilled and unskilled labor, because you need a mix of skilled and unskilled labor, because a skilled labor will be very costly. So you may one technical person is there and few unskilled person is there to support him. Then water and supply shortages. Then plant located in undeveloped zone and shipping and transport challenges. These can be some of the production and operation related challenges. Then the next category was economic and regulatory problem. Macroeconomic environment we have discussed many times, those which are not under control of the business organization especially. First one is poor economy or recession. Means people do not have surplus money to invest. Change in government policies. If government has changed some policy, your business may face some problem. Inflation is there. Liberalization of imports bringing cheaper substitutes. Means whenever we talk about even Chinese products are best example of this. If we are going for some product, Chinese product are much more economical or cheaper than other existing products. That is why without having any brand tag, most of the Chinese products are sold because of their price only. Then next we have activities related to... Yes, sir.
Dr. Chaudhary, I am sorry to disturb you.
No.
You have to resend that email because it is not rich or...
Okay.
So we are unable to show that PPT. Sir, in message box, you can see the email ID.
In message box.
In message box, email ID is there.
हेलो मनोज सर आपका मेल आया
ये मैंने अभी देखता हूँ मैं अभी क्या आया क्या सर? देखिए तो मिश्रा सर वाले उस पे आईडी पे।
हाँ सर आ गया।
आ गया
सर ना? ठीक ठीक है सर।
ओके सर मैं कंटिन्यू।
यस यस
ओके सर
ओके। Okay, so these are some of the activities of feasibility analysis. As I told you, we will be majorly discussing these analysis: technical feasibility analysis, market feasibility analysis, financial feasibility analysis, and analysis of organizational capabilities. So if we talk about first technical feasibility analysis, crucial technical specification should be there. Then design durability should be there. A standardization of engineering requirements, machine tool in instruments, workflow, what would be the process of work, then product development blueprint, how will you will be developing the product, then market feasibility study, market potential identification, where you have, how you are seeing potential for your product and services in the market, what type of potential is available, potential market share means how much market share you will be in a position to gain, then potential sales volume, then sales price projection, what will be the pricing of your price will of your product, how you will be pricing, then market testing. Market testing is basically when you are initially developing your product and testing it with a selected group of people who should be the representative of your target consumers. So market testing should be there. Then selection of the test, what type of test you will be doing. Then if we go with the financial feasibility analysis, required financial resources, what type of resources will be there. Then financing of current assets. Whenever we talk about business, we have two types of assets, current and fixed assets. So financing current assets. Necessary working capital, we need working capital also for the day-to-day activity. Then available financial resources, required borrowing, and potential source of fund. Different sources of fund we have already discussed. So which source of fund will be more feasible, which will be more beneficial? Only as I told you, debt is good, but going with only debt is not desired. You must have a mix of the funds, sources of funds, because every type of source of fund has its own advantage and disadvantage. Then analysis of organizational capability, personal requirement, what type of manpower you will be looking for, managerial requirement is there. Then determination of individual responsibilities, determination of required organization structure, what type of organization structure should be there, so either it should be flat or tall, or it either it should be line organization, different types of organization also we have discussed. So it depends on your product, on your service, on the your operation. Then organizational relations, potential organizational development, these are some of the feasibility analysis. And some more are there. In technical feasibility analysis, models prototype, what type of models you should be using, then product testing lab, testing field, field testing, product testing, lab testing and field testing, then plant location, where your plant should be located, desirable characteristics of plant site. Then again in market feasibility, actual market test. Initially you have done with a sample whom you expect that they will be that type of target consumers you will have. Then you are actually targeting, testing market. Then analysis of market, marketing planning issues. Then preferred channel of distribution, what will be different types of distribution channels are there. So for your product, for your services, which type of distribution channel will be best? Either you go from consumer to direct, from manufacturer to direct consumer, or you go for a longer chain. Then impact of promotional efforts, what type of promotional efforts will be more impactful. Then required distribution point, packaging considerations, price differentiation should be there. How you will be able to, how you are in a position to differentiate your price from your competitors. Then in financial feasibility analysis, other points are cost of borrowing, which type of finance you will be going for and what will be cost of the types of finance, sources of finance. Then repayment conditions, what type of repayment conditions will be there. Operation cost, variable cost is there. Projected cash flows, what type of cash flow you will be having, at what point of time, what cash flow in you will be getting. Then projected profitability, what will be your profitability chances, at what point of time you will be in a position to earn profit. Then competitive, for analysis of organizational capability, you will have to do competitive analysis, analyzing your business with your competitors. Then we are through with these two units, and at last, if some query is there, I will take. So let me move to project report preparation. We have discussed about different elements of this business plan. Then you will have to present this plan in a form of project. So how to prepare it, what should be there. So first, what is project report? Project report is basically any detailed or elaborated plan of the venture. So business plan helps an entrepreneur to form up the fuzzy concept that he has for or setting up a new venture. Means business plan mein jo bhi aapke paas kuch concept hai, general concept hai, usko aap ek documented form mein present karte hain. Isko hum short mein DPR bhi bolte hain, detailed project report. So detailed project report is nothing but a very elaborate plan of the venture. It ensures the program schedule, roles and responsibilities, all activities to be carried out, resource requirement, associated risk and mitigation measure for the venture. Means whatever you will be doing, whatever will be the process of business, everything is there in the project report. These are some of the importances of detailed project report, why it is important. It takes a relook at the financial planning in much greater detail, incorporating the system for monitoring and control of financial progress of the project. It will give you a detailed view of the activities of business. It covers the marketing strategy and demand forecast, all the activities related to marketing, जैसे जो भी हम ऑलरेडी डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. DPR contains the description of the plant and facility, everything related to operation. DPR provides a specification of choice of technology, technological collaborations, plant and machinery. Then location of the plant and associated consideration, जिसके अंदर सारा आपका मार्केट कहाँ होगा, पावर वाटर लेबर अवेबिलिटी, रेगुलेटरी फ्रेमवर्क, वेयर हाउसिंग सपोर्ट. अब जैसे इवन इंडिया के अंदर ही यदि हम देखें, अलग अलग स्टेट्स की अलग अलग प्रॉब्लम और फैसिलिटीज है. यदि हम बिजनेस के लिए बात करें तो कुछ स्टेट बहुत सारे फैसिलिटीज प्रोवाइड करवाते हैं, कुछ स्टेट्स में बहुत सारे रेस्ट्रिक्शंस हैं. Then since project depend on raw material for production, DPR presents the statistics of material requirement at different level of output so that shortage or overstocking can be avoided. Raw material का आपको overstocking भी नहीं करना है क्योंकि उसका handling cost बढ़ जाएगा. Shortage भी नहीं होना चाहिए क्योंकि उससे फिर आपका man power और machines, आपके जितने भी resources हैं वो idle बैठ जाएंगे. Two human skill required for smooth execution of project. From key human skills required for a smooth execution of project. Project from commission to operation are presented in the DPR. So the human skills are also described in it. Then next we have features of a good project report. But prior to it, we have one more slide. For whom a DPR is made? जैसे आप जो ये project report बना रहे हैं, वो किन के लिए बनाते हैं? तो सबसे पहला है the promoting entrepreneur and the partners. जो भी entrepreneur है, promoting उसके लिए और partners के लिए जो business में partner हैं या हो सकते हैं. फिर bankers and other investors जिनसे आप फाइनेंस के लिए जिनको आप अप्रोच करेंगे, देन गवर्नमेंट एंड इट्स रेगुलेटरी बॉडीज. रेगुलेटरी बॉडीज से बहुत सारे आपको मतलब अप्रूवल्स की जरूरत होती है. जैसे आगे हम एनवायरनमेंट का डिस्कस करेंगे, एनवायरनमेंट प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट 2000 आई थिंक समथिंग एनवायरनमेंट प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट इज देयर, हियर आई एम नॉट रिमेम्बरिंग. सो यू विल हैव टू फॉर सर्टेन बिजनेस यू विल हैव टू गेट अप्रूवल फ्रॉम दोज. And other many approvals are required. Key personnel of the venture, whom you can describe it. Technology providers, यदि आपके business plan में पूरा detailed है, तो जो technology provider है, वो अच्छे position में होगा आपको best technology suggest करने में. Okay, then next we have service providers are there. Now next week our topic is features of a good project report. First one is reader friendly. It should be there. Reader should be easily able to understand those project whatever there in the project. Then simple and unambiguous language. Language should not be very technical or hi-fi, because if you are using technical language, the language related to business, bank people may not be able to understand that. Then organized and well structured, it should be there. It should be factual. जैसे हवा में बहुत सारी बातें नहीं होनी चाहिए. Measurable result and outcome oriented. उस जो भी आपके results होंगे, उसको measurable होना चाहिए. वो आपका जो business activity है, वो outcome oriented होना चाहिए. और इसको timely prepare किया जाना चाहिए. Then coming to format of a DPR for business. एक DPR का क्या structure होना चाहिए, format होना चाहिए. तो सबसे पहला है कि वो उसका एक attractive cover page आप चाहिए. उसके बाद index. Index में simply आपके उस report के अंदर क्या क्या चीजें हैं वो detail में होना चाहिए, with page number and everything, so that यदि कोई कुछ किसी भी हिस्से को देखना चाहता है तो वो उसे आसानी से देख सकता है. Then general information आपके business से related और इससे related चीजें जो जो होनी चाहिए हम आगे detail में देखेंगे. फिर promoters details should be there, marketing planning should be there, technical arrangement, production process होना चाहिए, environmental aspect क्या क्या है, schedule of implementation किस तरीके से उसको आप implement करेंगे, किस किस phases में implement करेंगे, financial aspect of the project, means of finance, profitability estimates and appraisals, human resource planning and socio-economic considerations. So let us see one by one. General information में क्या क्या होना चाहिए. सबसे पहला नाम, उसके बाद constitution and sector. फिर किस sector में आप business कर रहे हैं, आपके business का location क्या होगा, name of industry and product, किस इंडस्ट्री से आपका होगा, आपका प्रोडक्ट का नाम क्या होगा, इसके प्रमोटर्स कौन है और उनका क्या किसका क्या कंट्रीब्यूशन रहेगा इसमें, क्योंकि अब बहुत सारे बैड डेट्स होने के बाद अब जो गवर्नमेंट ने एक नया फाइनेंस में स्पेशली लोन्स में चेंज किया है रिसेंटली, दैट इज दे आर मेकिंग डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एज को बोरोअर, द प्रोविजन इज देयर एंड बैंक्स आर वर्किंग ऑन दैट, मीन्स वो यदि किसी एक्स वाई जेड कंपनी को लोन दे रहे हैं तो साथ में उसके डायरेक्टर्स को भी वो को बोरोअर बना रहे हैं, तो उस हिसाब से प्रमोटर्स क्या है और उनकी क्या क्या रिस्पॉन्स कंट्रीब्यूशन क्या है उनका, एंड कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट एंड मीन्स ऑफ फाइनेंस, आपके प्रोजेक्ट का कॉस्ट क्या होगा और कहाँ कहाँ से आप फाइनेंस लेंगे, क्योंकि जनरली बैंक 100% फाइनेंस नहीं देता है, आप अपना कितना लगा रहे हैं, आपको बैंक से कितना चाहिए या फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन से कितना चाहिए। देन नेक्स्ट वी हैव मार्केट प्लानिंग, मार्केट प्लानिंग में सबसे पहले डिमांड फॉरकास्टिंग होगा कि आपका जो भी आप प्रोडक्ट बनाने जा रहे हैं या जो भी आप सर्विस प्रोवाइड करेंगे उसकी डिमांड मार्केट में है या नहीं, लोगों आपके प्रोडक्ट को खरीदने वाले हैं या नहीं। देन टारगेट मार्केट डिसीजन, किस मार्केट में कौन सा आपका टारगेट मार्केट होगा, मार्केट शेयर एस्टिमेशन, किस टाइम पीरियड में कितने समय बाद आपके पास कितना मार्केट शेयर होगा उस पर्टिकुलर इंडस्ट्री का, फिर आपकी मार्केटिंग स्ट्रेटजी क्या होगी, किस तरीके से आप मार्केट में एंटर करेंगे, अलग अलग मार्केट की जो भी आप एक्टिविटीज करेंगे मार्केट से रिलेटेड, मार्केटिंग से रिलेटेड। देन मार्केटिंग मिक्स, मार्केटिंग मिक्स में बेसिकली हम 4 P's की बात करते हैं, दैट इज प्रोडक्ट प्राइस प्लेस प्रमोशन, यदि हम सर्विस सेक्टर में हैं तो वहां फिर 7 P's की बात करते हैं, बट उतना डिटेल में अभी नहीं जाऊंगा मैं, बेसिकली यहाँ पे मार्केटिंग मिक्स में आपका प्रोडक्ट क्या होगा, आपका प्लेस कहाँ पे होगा, प्राइसिंग क्या होगी आपकी और आप प्रमोशनल स्ट्रेटजी कैसे करेंगे, क्योंकि प्रमोशन के बिना आपके बिजनेस के बारे में लोग जानेंगे नहीं, तो वो इम्पोर्टेंट है। प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च स्ट्रेटजी, किस तरीके से आप प्रोडक्ट लॉन्च करेंगे, किस समय पे करेंगे। देन मार्केटिंग शेड्यूल आपका क्या होगा, मार्केटिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन क्या होंगे और नॉन ट्रेडिशनल चैनल ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन आपका क्या होगा, किस तरीके से आप इनोवेटिव डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन चैनल को यूज करेंगे। देन नेक्स्ट टेक्निकल अरेंजमेंट के ऊपर आपको डिटेल देना होगा कि आपकी चॉइस ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी क्या है, टेक्नोलॉजी के लिए आप किन किन के साथ कोलैबोरेट कर रहे हैं। देन इक्विपमेंट एंड प्रोसेस टेक्नोलॉजी डिटेल क्या होगा, किस कौन कौन से इक्विपमेंट आप यूज करेंगे। देन लेआउट ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट कैसा होगा, आपके जो भी प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम होगा उसका, फिर प्लांट एंड इक्विपमेंट की क्या स्पेसिफिकेशन होंगे, कहाँ पे प्लांट होगा, कौन सा होगा, इक्विपमेंट कौन कौन से यूज किए जाएंगे। देन नेक्स्ट वन इज प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस, इन दिस प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस लोकेशन ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट हैज टू बी डिसाइडेड, कैपेसिटी प्लानिंग शुड बी देयर, ऑपरेशनल प्लानिंग शुड बी देयर, मटीरियल रिक्वायरमेंट शुड बी देयर, इनपुट आउटपुट डिसीजंस, देन क्वालिटी पैरामीटर्स, किस तरीके का क्वालिटी आप एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं, ऑपरेशंस कॉस्टिंग क्या क्या होगी आपकी, फिर प्लांट एंड प्लांट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड पर्सनल, वेंडर मैनेजमेंट, वेंडर्स के साथ आप किस तरीके से मैनेज करेंगे, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एंड स्टोरेज की आपके पास क्या फैसिलिटी है, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन के लिए आप किसी थर्ड पार्टी के साथ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे, खुद पहुँचाएंगे, अपनी ट्रांसपोर्ट फैसिलिटी होगी, स्टोरेज के लिए आपके पास फिनिश्ड गुड्स के लिए कितने दिन का आप स्टॉक मेंटेन करके रखेंगे, एंड देन फॉर प्लांट सेफ्टी व्हाट विल बी द मेजर्स। देन नेक्स्ट वी हैव एनवायरमेंटल एस्पेक्ट, बेस लेवल एनवायरमेंटल पैरामीटर्स, आपके बिजनेस से रिलेटेड जो भी एनवायरमेंटल पैरामीटर्स है उसको आपको फॉलो करना चाहिए, इम्पैक्ट ऑन एयर वाटर एंड सॉइल, जितने भी हमारे देश में नदियां या वायु गंदे हो रहे हैं, बहुत सारे आपने इस लॉकडाउन के पीरियड में देखा होगा कि 15 दिनों में गंगा जी साफ हो गई, यमुना जी का जो पॉल्यूशन लेवल है बहुत कम आ गया, फिर हवा साफ हो गई, पंजाब से ही धौलाधार के सारे पहाड़ी चेन दिख रहे हैं, या व्हाटएवर सो ऑल दीज आर इम्पैक्ट ऑफ बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस ओनली. उनसे जो पॉल्यूशन आता है वो पानी में जाता है, हवा में जाता है, मिट्टी में जाता है. तो गवर्नमेंट ने इसके लिए बहुत सारे रूल्स बनाए हुए हैं जिसको आपको फॉलो करना चाहिए. फिर लॉज एंड कंप्लायंसेस रिलेटेड टू एनवायरनमेंट. देन डिफरेंट शेड्यूल ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन. फर्स्ट वन इज फेजेज ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट. कौन कौन से आपके डिफरेंट फेजेज होंगे प्रोजेक्ट के. Then deliverables in each phases, major activity in each deliverable, key milestones, आपके कौन कौन से key milestones होंगे, responsibility allocation, कौन सा individual, कौन सा manpower, किन की क्या क्या responsibility होगी, and Gantt chart for project solution. Basically ये technique है project solution का, scheduling का. तो उस हिसाब से आपको फिर किस तरीके से आप अपने project scheduling को करेंगे. Then next we have financial aspect of the project. इसमें cost projection है, revenue projections है, working capital requirement है. Working capital requirement आपकी क्या है, उसके आपने बहुत सारे techniques पढ़े होंगे. Then interest component. यदि आप debt के साथ जाते हैं तो उसका क्या क्या interest component होगा. Phased requirements of fund. किस किस phase में आपको कितने requirement, fund की requirement होती है. Then pre-operative and preliminary expenses, जो operation start करने से पहले आपके क्या expenses होंगे और initial क्या क्या expenses होंगे. क्योंकि जब आप business शुरू करते हैं उससे पहले भी आपके बहुत सारे expenses होते हैं. जैसे even हो सकता है आप business plan बनाते समय ही आप किसी expert की मदद लें तो वहां पे आपको उनका fee देना पड़ेगा. फिर projected tax calculation. Means of finances already we have discussed. Internal source of finance can be promoters fund, can be external sources of fund can be. Then provision for contingency. Finance में already MCOM के आप लोग student हैं. हर एक उसमें even यदि आप working capital भी decide करते हैं तो उसमें सारा calculate करने के बाद 10-20% contingency रखना पड़ता है. जो आपने पहले plan नहीं किया है that is for unplanned expense. Then next profitability estimates and appraisal. उसमें आपको डालना पड़ेगा. उसमें assumptions should be there. Projected income statement. कब आपकी कितनी income आने वाली है. फिर projected balance sheet. Projected cash flow statement. And appraisal based on profitability statement. तो ये सारे आपके होने चाहिए. Human resource planning. कहाँ से आप बेस्ट मैन पावर लेंगे और कैसे लेंगे. की पर्सनल रिक्वायरमेंट आपकी क्या होगी. हायरिंग और कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एग्रीमेंट, कॉन्ट्रेक्चुअल एग्रीमेंट कैसा होगा. आप हायर करेंगे परमानेंट एम्प्लॉय हायर करेंगे, कंपनी के रोल पे हायर करेंगे, आउटसोर्सिंग करेंगे, उन्हें फिर आप ट्रेनिंग किस तरीके से देंगे. और अपेंडिसेस जो लास्ट में आपको डॉक्यूमेंट्स लगाने होते हैं उसमें एस्टिमेट्स ऑफ कॉस्ट प्रोडक्शन होना चाहिए. कैलकुलेशन ऑफ डेप्रिसिएशन. Then calculation of working capital and margin money for working capital, repayment interest schedule of long term loans and bank finance, calculation of tax and coverage ratio. ये सारी चीजें होनी चाहिए आपके project report. Report ये इतना detailed आपका होना चाहिए. Means whatever you are going to do in business, everything should be there on paper. Then next we have जो कुछ गलतियां करते हैं लोग प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट बनाते समय. कॉमन एरर्स मेड वाइल प्रिपेयरिंग डीपीआर. एंटरप्रेन्योर्स डिसाइड टू प्रिपेयर द डीपीआर ऑन हिज और हर ओन विद सम हेल्प फ्रॉम फ्रेंड्स टू सेव एक्सपेंस. जैसे कि मैंने आपको बताया कि कई बार आपको एक्सपर्ट्स का हेल्प लेना चाहिए प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट बनाते समय. और यदि आप उस एक्सपर्ट के फी का खर्चा बचाने के लिए खुद से ही बना लेते हैं या एक आधे दोस्त की मदद से बना लेते हैं तो हो सकता है आप बहुत इफेक्टिव प्रोजेक्ट बिजनेस प्लान ना बना पाए. इफ एंटरप्रेन्योर इन्वॉल्व हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ फुल टाइम इन प्रिपेयरिंग डीपीआर, द मोर इम्पोर्टेंट टास्क लाइक लाइज विद इन्वेस्टर, रेगुलेटरी एजेंसी, रिफाइनिंग द प्रोटोटाइप एटसेट्रा आर नेग्लेक्टेड. यदि वो ज्यादा अपना फोकस लगाएगा केवल प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट बनाने पे ही तो बाकी जो जरूरी काम है वो इग्नोर हो जाएगा. बोरोइंग और कॉपिंग डीपीआर ऑफ सम अदर प्रोजेक्ट सिमिलर इन नेचर टू सेव टाइम एंड मनी. क्योंकि हर इंडिविजुअल का डिफरेंट कॉन्सेप्ट था, उसने जो बनाया वो अलग तरीके से सोच रहा होगा, हो सकता है आप वैसा नहीं सोच रहे, तो किसी और का कॉपी करना भी गलत हो सकता है. अपॉइंटिंग द कंसल्टेंसी फर्म और इंडिविजुअल ऑन लॉन्च और हेयर से विदाउट ड्यू डिलीजेंस इन द फील्ड. फिर नेक्स्ट है नॉट साइनिंग अ लीगली बाइंडिंग एग्रीमेंट विद द एजेंसी और इंडिविजुअल, आपने लीगल बाइंडिंग एग्रीमेंट साइन नहीं किया है. नॉट हैविंग कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी क्लॉज इन द एग्रीमेंट, हो सकता है आपने जो किसी के साथ शेयर किया उसने किसी और के साथ शेयर करके आपको नेग्लेक्ट करके, सपोज आपने 4 वेंचर कैपिटलिस्ट को अप्रोच किया, उसने उसको आपने अपने बिजनेस प्लान का एक कॉपी दिया स्टडी करने के लिए और कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी क्लॉज नहीं था, उसने वो किसी और के साथ शेयर करके स्टार्ट कर लिया बिजनेस. Then not sharing all the details in the proposed project with the consultant, resorting the to false fact and figures or window dressing the DPR to make it attractive to certain sector of stakeholders. Means उसको realistic रखना है, attractive नहीं बनाना. Not presenting the realistic and true picture. आप realistic और true picture present नहीं कर रहे. So all these can be some of the mistakes which are done by the entrepreneur during making this DPR. Now we are in the last part of our this lecture, that is project appraisal. So first, what is a project? Projects are the cutting edge of development. Projects are an investment activity in which financial resources are expended to create capital assets and that produce benefits over the extended period of time. The Chartered Management of Institute defined a project as an activity that has a beginning and an end which carried out to achieve a particular purpose to a set क्वालिटी विद इन गिवन टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट एंड कॉस्ट लिमिट. मीन्स ये क्या है, ये एक बिगनिंग और एंड तक पूरा जो भी एक्टिविटी आप कैरी आउट करने वाले हैं उसका पूरा का पूरा डिटेल डिस्क्रिप्शन. ये कुछ डिफरेंस है इन डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ प्रोजेक्ट एंड अ प्लान वो प्रोग्राम. तो ये पॉइंट वाइज है, इसको आप लोग देख सकते हैं. We are already short of time, तो आगे हम बढ़ते हैं. Now criteria of project appraisal, किन किन क्राइटेरियाज पे किया जाता है, ये एक इसका टेक्निकल एस्पेक्ट होता है, इंस्टीट्यूशनल एस्पेक्ट इज देयर, ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल एस्पेक्ट इज देयर, मैनेजीरियल एस्पेक्ट इज देयर, सोशल एस्पेक्ट इज देयर, कॉमर्शियल एस्पेक्ट इज देयर, financial, economic and sustainability. On all these criteria, project appraisal is done. Means how technically you are feasible, institutionally you are going to work, then organizationally how you will be, managerial aapke kya kya competencies hai, kya kya aapke plus positives hai, then social aspect kya hai iska related to your project, aapke project ka सोशल एस्पेक्ट क्या है, फिर कॉमर्शियली हाउ यू विल बी डूइंग योर बिजनेस, हाउ यू विल बी मैक्सिमाइजिंग योर प्रोडक्ट, मैक्सिमाइजिंग योर वेल्थ, हाउ यू विल बी गोइंग फॉर फाइनेंशियल एक्टिविटीज, हाउ यू व्हाट विल बी द इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज एंड हाउ यू विल बी सस्टेनिंग योर बिजनेस. तो इन सारे क्राइटेरियाज के ऊपर प्रोजेक्ट का अप्रेजल किया जाता है. अब कुछ ये प्रोजेक्ट अप्रेजल टेक्निक्स हैं, यहाँ पे जितनी भी चीजें हैं वो आपने डिटेल में जरूर किया होगा विद द हेल्प ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल्स. इसके दो बेसिकली मेथड हैं, एक है डिस्काउंटिंग टेक्निक और दूसरा नॉन डिस्काउंटिंग टेक्निक. तो नॉन डिस्काउंटिंग टेक्निक में पहले है अर्जेंसी है, दूसरा पे बैक पीरियड है. पे बैक पीरियड इज जैसे आज आपने जो भी अमाउंट इन्वेस्ट किया कितने समय बाद आपको वो वापस मिल जाएगा, आपका पे बैक पीरियड क्या है. फिर तीसरा है अकाउंटिंग रेट ऑफ रिटर्न इज देयर, देन डेट सर्विस कवरेज रेशियो इज देयर. तो इन सब का आपके वैसे स्टडी मटेरियल में भी इसका डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड फॉर्मूला वगैरह दिए गए हैं, बट सिंस यू ऑल आर students of MCOM, you must have done all these things in very detail. Then discounting जो criteria होता है, क्योंकि मैंने आपको बताया, पहले भी बताया था, and you must be aware कि जो आज जितना अमाउंट आप इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं उसकी वैल्यू जितनी आज है, आज से दो साल बाद, चार साल बाद या एक साल बाद उसकी उतनी वैल्यू नहीं होती है. तो उसके लिए यदि आप आज कैलकुलेट करते हैं तो उसको डिस्काउंट करते हैं फ्यूचर वैल्यू को. सो नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू मेथड इज देयर, एनपीवी मेथड, आईआरआर, इंटरनल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न, बेनिफिट कॉस्ट रेशियो एंड एनुअल कैपिटल चार्जेस. So these are some of the project appraisal techniques. I am not going in detail of these things since I expect you people must be aware about these terminology and all other things. So I am through with the lecture. If anyone has any question, please feel free to ask.
हेलो
हेलो
यस सर.
हाँ, एनी क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम एनी लर्नर्स?
फ्रॉम एनी लर्नर्स
हीरो सर, हीरो सर, अभी छुट्टी, यदि ये नहीं ना क्वेश्चंस नहीं ना जल्दी आने वाइंड अप
मीटिंग आरंभ हो रहा है ना. यस सर, यस सर, सर सर क्लोज कर दूं.
Okay,
okay,
sir. So, last I would like to thank our resource person Dr. Chaudhary for a wonderful presentation. Speaker, we have to wind up very soon because we have a meeting today, right after this one.
Okay.
So, I apologize for that. And so, thank you, learners. We came to end of the wonderful class. So, have a good day. Stay safe. Thank you so much. Please disconnect yourself from the platform.
Thank you, sir.